Dennehy was an all-star defenseman at BC High and Deerfield Academy. But when it came time for college, only two schools came calling.
I was the oldest, and so I was sort of the guinea pig for my family. I had never known anyone who was being recruited by a college for a Division I sport. And so I guess I just assumed that to have two schools coming after you was a blessing. At least you had a choice.
With that typically positive attitude, Mark chose Boston College over Princeton. He wanted to be closer to home. And to his surprise, saw action on the BC Blue Line in 30 of the Eagles' 34 games as a freshman.
I felt accepted right from the start. You know, the coaches were very honest with me coming in, and that's one of the things that I liked about it. For me, it was more of a challenge. I don't think they expected me to play as much as I did my freshman year. And I know I sure didn't. But so I looked at it as a challenge.
By accepting that challenge, Mark quickly proved himself to be a quality Division I player.
Dennehy scores, and no doubt about that one.
What has impressed his coach most over the past 4 years are his work ethic and his ability to lead.
The thing that I think Mark Dennehy has that some kids may not have is a real desire to improve. I think it's just the fact that he's being the only senior defenseman that have. I think he's done a good job with the kids bringing him along. He's a kind of a kid, as you know, that he's always trying to help somebody, and he takes particular pleasure, I think, in trying to help the young kids on the team.
Hard work and leadership have also led to success in the classroom, where Dennehy is a Dean's List student in the School of Management. Just talk to him for a few minutes, and it becomes quite clear that his mother has been his guide.
I learned most of my leadership qualities from my mom. You know, my parents are separated, and when I was 12 years old, you know, I was the oldest male in the house. And for a 12-year-old, that's pretty devastating. But my mom just sort of assumed both roles so well, and I saw that growing up, that I think for me, it taught me that leadership is what you make of it.
Mom is Patricia Dennehy, and she's not only Mark's biggest fan, but also one of his best friends. A permanent fixture at Kelly Rink, Pat's influence on her oldest son has been profound.
The woman's amazing, you know. She's raised three kids on her own. She put herself through nursing school. In essence, she got me into college. I wrote all my college essays about her. If there's ever anything that my mom's taught me, you know, it's that you don't have to play with the hand that's been dealt you. You know, you can dig deep and work at things, and they'll work out.
Never was that advice more important than following his parents' separation when Mark was just a boy. He was forced to grow up in a hurry.
When you're 12 years old, you're bright-eyed, and you think your dad's Superman and your mom's Lois Lane. And when this happens, you realize that they're just human beings. And so I did a lot of growing up in that first year. You look at the world in a different perspective. You know, you put hockey into its perspective. And for me, hockey had always been my life. And at that point, it became fun. And when it started to become fun, I started to improve as a player and enjoy it more.
Mark and the Eagles will hopefully be enjoying a run at the national championship the next 2 months, and hockey will never be far from his mind. Perspective, however, is one thing that Mark Dennehy understands, and family is always first.
When I see Dennehy on the back of a shirt, it gives me a sense of pride, because I know that it represents my whole family, not just me, and my family means a lot to me.